Europe tries to sleep. Kiev streetlights glow. Ports along the Black Sea hustle under floodlights. NATO command centers buzz quietly in the background, always watching, always waiting. But above the quiet surface of night, the most dangerous weapons in modern warfare lurk out of sight. The nuclear-powered 9M730 Burevestnik, reportedly tested with a 14,000-kilometer flight in approximately 15 hours, now presented as a missile able to fly unpredictable low-altitude profiles to bypass defenses. The hypersonic 3M22 Zircon, officially in Russian Navy service, with reported speeds of Mach 8 to 9. The KH-47M2 Kinzhal, already used in Ukraine, diving from high altitude at terrifying speed. And the Iskander-M, Russia's most frequent precision ballistic strike system in this war. These weapons are symbols of a new era, one where reaction time shrinks to seconds and an entire city's fate can change before you finish reading a single message. So tonight, we ask the question that even NATO does not want to say out loud. If these four missiles ever strike together, how many of them must be stopped to prevent a catastrophe? It begins where war usually hides, on the ground. The Iskander-M doesn't just fly, it hunts. Mobile launchers reposition under forest cover, fire, then vanish before satellites blink. Its quasi-ballistic flight makes it far harder to predict and intercept while maneuvering and using decoys in the terminal phase. Each missile takes mere minutes to cross borders, and in those minutes, operators must pick. Defend a power plant supplying frontline brigades, or a hospital grid supporting the wounded, or a Patriot radar that may need to stop something even deadlier next. Defense planners classify Iskander as a SAID / dead opener, suppression of enemy air defenses. It punches a hole in defenses and dares the attackers behind it to walk through. Tonight, that hole is the entrance to something much darker. From the upper atmosphere, death falls like a silent blade. The KH-47M2 Kinzhal is launched from high-speed aircraft, most notably MiG-31K interceptors, and dives toward targets at hypersonic velocity already confirmed in combat. Radar sees it for seconds. Patriot launches, if they can. Interceptors fly, if they're not already depleted by Iskander. Even a successful interception is a strategic drain. One Kinzhal fired, one or more expensive interceptors spent shell. Russia gathers intel from each engagement. Pressure shifts to Ukraine's air defense reserves. Kinzhal is not designed to flatten cities. It is meant to decapitate a nation, a command bunker, a key weapons depot, an F-16 runway, and it only needs one breakthrough to rewrite the map. A dagger doesn't swing wildly. It aims for the heart. Now the sea awakens. The 3M22 Zircon rises from a naval cell or a coastal launcher, tipping over into a scramjet-powered hypersonic glide at reported Mach 8 to 9. It was crafted to shatter aircraft carriers, the ultimate naval prey. But OSINT analysis has linked Zircon debris to land strikes in Ukraine, proving adaptation to the current conflict. For defenders, that changes everything. A missile once threatening NATO fleets can now hit ports, oil terminals, power plants, even inland bases before defense systems can refresh their firing solutions. This creates a multi-domain nightmare. From the sky, Kinzhal. From the ground, Iskander from the sea, Zircon. And each one forces NATO commanders to ask, where do we defend first when everywhere is a first target? Then comes the threat no missile shield is designed for. Russia claims the 9M730 Burevestnik can. fly low to evade radar, maneuver mid-flight, reach approximately 14,000 kilometers in 15 hours, stay airborne for hours thanks to a nuclear propulsion system. Western experts respond with caution. Previous tests have reportedly failed. Incidents involving radiation risks have been documented, but missile defense relies on probabilities. And Burevestnik changes the equation to something far more chilling, a threat that can come from anywhere, whenever someone decides now. Russia wouldn't need to fire it at a city. They only need to announce it is in the sky. A nuclear-capable missile circling in silence is enough to make every capital ask, where is it heading, and who decides where it lands? This video does not celebrate these weapons. It exposes the reality of what exists in this war, using only publicly verifiable information and marking disputed claims clearly. No classified details, no tactical instructions, no misinformation. This narrative is for education, so every viewer can understand the technology behind modern escalation. See how seconds define survival. Realize that civilians live beneath these flight paths every day. Recognize the urgency of diplomacy and effective defense. The most horrifying thing here is not the missiles themselves. It is the fact that a single error, a misread radar track, a failed interceptor, a wrong political assumption, could transform a quiet night into a chapter of history that nobody wants to write. Modern war has entered the era of the 10-second warning. And before it changes the world forever, we must understand what's flying in the dark.